So, dann können wir den nächsten Talk ja beginnen. Von Eva Olivin und Robert Fersch.
Hi and welcome to the translation of the Es gibt viel zu tun, hauen wir ab Talk. This is Kati and Felix and we'll be your translation team for today.
Sozusagen nach unten kippen. Zwei Schritte nach vorne.
So just go two steps ahead.
Und mal 45 Grad nach oben.
And now 45 degrees upwards.
If you can't see the video right now, they're showing a video or whatever they're doing. Yeah, the art project basically.
Und mal 90 Grad.
So now go 90 degrees left. Oh.
Und dann mal 180.
And then 180 degrees.
Zehn Grad nach links.
10 degrees left.
Okay. Nochmal 3 Grad nach links.
All right. So 3 degrees left again.
Ein Schritt nach vorne.
One step forward.
Bisschen hoch.
A little bit up. Unfortunately, you can't read it.
10 Grad nach links.
10 degrees to the left.
Und mal 30 Grad nach
and hoch. Now 30 degrees down.
Nochmal 10.
Additional 10.
Eva Olivi und ich, Robert Ferch, wir
Eva and me, Robert Ferch, we're not from the hacker scene,
sondern wir machen eigentlich kontextbezogene
we're doing context driven art. And this time we went to the hacker scene context, but before we arrived there, you just saw in the video how we imagined such a robot that was a visit to the apartment that will be the topic today. Eva was the roboter, me the controller, a little bit to the left, a little bit to the right, in the way robots would behave. And that was before we collaborated with the Kaustreff Chemnitz and the Sublab Leipzig at the very beginning of our project.
Und dieses Projekt heißt
this project is called There's so much to do, let's just leave. These words were found on a postcard over 20 years old, 20 years forsaken apartment. And they became the title of this work because they were very descriptive of what we found. And before we could find this apartment, it had to be found by someone else, by Lars Fassmann. He is a supporter of very active persons in Chemnitz. He has a bought a house in Chemnitz, and when he got the keys for this house, the former owner was telling him about this apartment, which has not been entered for 20 years, but was still completely full of objects, but the former proprietor was not there anymore. And of course, she wasn't very happy about that. Lars was very interested in this apartment and he wanted to do more than just clean it up. And therefore, he talked to artists he already knew. And many of them listened to that and looked at it and were overwhelmed.
Dann sprach auch Eva
and then he talked to Eva, who told me, and we were skeptical at first, because an empty apartment, social decline that's everywhere in Chemnitz. Chemnitz has lost 20,000 people and whole streets are empty. So an empty apartment isn't very special in Chemnitz. But what Eva described to me was very interesting and very special. She told me about this apartment and was completely dark, even at day, because the whole of the apartment, all the windows are completely closed because of plants.
In den restlichen Wohnungen, nicht in allen, aber in einigen wird noch gewohnt.
Some of these apartments are still in use, but this part is completely forgotten. Everything in there has been kept as if the former person living there would be returning any day. And it's more like a time travel, as if you enter the moment the person living there left the last time. And when you came in,
it was,
you immediately became very sensitive and were talking not very loud, and you were trying to not interrupt anything, even though, of course, there was nobody there, as not to change anything there. So we were clear that this apartment is very special, and the objects of everyday life that are located there are reflecting, of course, the time of the Wende, the end of the Berlin Wall, and of course they reflect on the political landscape of that time. There are many reasons to leave or wanting to leave, and what's left in the apartment is giving many hints as to why he may have left, but it can never be precise. And the more we talked about it, the question we came back to was, why would you leave your apartment like that? So it's definitely an interesting apartment,
and
just because we were very interested and we could easily have made money from that. Some people are doing that, and while we were researching, we were looking at this article. That's not our apartment, but someone found this other apartment that was not inhabited since 1980, and you can look at it, and it's very interesting to just Google this article and look at the images.
Ich habe ein bisschen das Gefühl, die haben da teilweise Bilder mit Bildunterschriften vertauscht.
It seems as if the titles are not matching with the images. So I'm
seit dem Weggang des Bewohners haben allenfalls
since the person living there left, only the house management has entered, or maybe love couples, so it's completely untouched. So as you can see on this photo, you hopefully won't return to your apartment in this state. So why we're showing this is that the article proves that something that is a lot less interesting received a lot of media echo from the FAZ and many other media outlets. So we could have used our apartment to just take a few pictures and tell about the story, and we would have generated some interest. But we thought it was just a rather normal apartment,
but
wanted to base our work on it. So how can we open the door for interested persons without inviting a lot of hobos and clumsy oafs? So how can we do it with minimal collateral damage?
Well,
some people know that this is possible with these machines without collateral damage. This is a drone. If you find a relic from older days today, we use technical means to view them. Technical seems like a clean and objective way, and we were thinking about drone pilots and everything, and these technical means are not always objective and clean, as we always thought. So we wanted to have this flat, you know, when where everyone shudders, kind of. We wanted to have people see and to ask ourselves how empathetic can we handle this thing. And we wanted to show the flat, and with every step we still ask ourselves, are we allowed to do this right now? All the time we were feeling like this is not okay. And now the question is, how empathetic can you be if you can't really cross a classic step? And how will people handle the flat without using drones and everything? And
wie fühlt eigentlich die Nachbarschaft, wenn sie diese Schicksale sehen?
How does the neighborhood feel if they know that this flat, what this flat has in it, and when they see what happens? There's a close flat, and a few hundred meters we got a flat where we could base our operations. We decided to have to keep the flat closed, and we needed something like the Mars Rover. But this is a no-budget project we have, and we are not able to have all the features Mars Curiosity have. And we still had this naivety, and you know, we needed someone with knowledge of that to build us a small rover to look at the flat. Chemnitz has a so-called chaos trap. It's a hackerspace. We tried to reach them, and we went there with a box of Mate, and they already had a huge pile of Mate, by the way, but still, maybe it was nice. It was a nice gesture to go there with it. In the chaos trap, people were quite interested in our work, and they have the know-how to do that. And in the next meeting, we were able to bring better presence. And we bought a remote tank you can steer with a remote control. And we made a simple sketch what we wanted to do. In the circle we see in the upper left we see the robots in a schematic way. Just down below you can see a house and a chimney, and inside there's the flat with 8 cameras, and on the other side just a simple control station. And we needed streams and transmission between the flat, the robot, and the station, the investigation station over there. And we had to set up a multiplexer, and we split them on different monitors, and we used the Freifunk. It's an open Wi-Fi there, and we needed backups. For example, like we used the little disk as an image for that. And what's also important is we needed some kind of interruption where you can see the little lock and the wall. There's a kill switch that stops the transmission as soon as we have to take care of the rover. So this was the idea we had on the technical means. But I might have thought about this in a more technical way, so that would be a little bit optimistic. So only the setup with 15 machines getting for free is a little difficult. And that was just one of the problems we had.
Und natürlich
but also, you know, it's also not not only difficult to have all the hardware. On the other side, we see other hardware we needed. And this is not the whole effect we had, because we needed soft and hardware. And there's still soft factors we had to think about. And we as artists didn't really want to make something that people can see and can visit. We wanted to make something that's experimental, where everyone had to take part and, you know, to think about the situation. And we had to kind of ditch the art surrounding, because
we
didn't want to have people
doing weird stuff.
And for this intervention, we got a bar, and this bar had an anniversary, and we wanted to be able to have the anniversary guests being our guests as well.
And here's
a little example for the design. So these are the rooms beside the apartment.
We
had to put all these rooms in scene, and
we put
a little bin right in the corner, you know, like as authentical as it was possible.
And in this moment,
the first time we got the feeling from the neighbors were thinking like, what the fuck are they doing there, basically. But we came closer in the work.
So you see, we did have fire extinguishers, and people immediately had this work office environment. And on the other side of the wall, we had the station with two desks. The left desk had 9 monitors, and the right one had 1 very big monitor. And both of them got a keyboard, and the right one additionally has a joystick. And the middle, there's a paper tray that divides both desks. And maybe you can see on the left monitor, there's the streams from the forsaken flat. And on the right-hand side, you see a lock window. And we wanted it to be just as forsaken as the flat, wanted to seem just as forsaken as the flat, and we didn't make any advertisements for this art project. We just wanted that the guests trip over our art project. So the first thing we did was this initial protocol was fixed to this magnet board, and it said, flat, second floor, tenant cannot be found, probably lost since, forsaken since 20 years, personal objects are still there. So what could be the reason to leave a flat like this? And what we were interested in was the answer to this question. So the participants couldn't tell us, but they could open a protocol window and could fill in some text. And the questions were analyzed, the images, comments and personal comments. And the idea was that people could print that and take that with them, but most of the people who were there put it on the magnet board as well. And there were many interesting things we could see there. But this is our setup, and this is where the investigation begins. This is how we call this phase. And we didn't change anything from there on. And we would have thought it was great if nobody had touched a joystick. But on the other hand, of course, we would be disappointed because it had worked. So on the 4th April 2014, the experiment started. It lasted 3 days, and the first guests were very unsecure. Nobody sits down, people just touch the joystick and see if the monitors react. And of course, the young people who came in, who didn't, of course, not read the manual that we layouted in Word, so it looks just like, well, it would probably look, but they just try out the hardware. And I've got a small video of the persons on the left desk could see, while the robot was being directed through the flat.
By the way, we would comment the video, but there's no sound. So we just have to wait until the video is over, in case you're just listening to the audio stream.
Und
so,
ja, jetzt haben wir diese Bilder,
we've seen those images, and what surprised us, and of course I showed it to demonstrate the quality of the transmission, but what was really interesting with every entry to this flat, every time I went there, you didn't think any less that the tenant would return any moment. And this weird feeling, this we hardly saw this weird feeling with the people who were using the joystick. And of course, these people left some comments, and they're very interesting because the you see that the interest for the hardware is a lot greater than the surroundings they're using the hardware in. So here's one from Rico. Robot doesn't work really well, just play toy.
Es gibt aber dann auch besondere Wahrnehmung.
So there's some people seeing special. So Bold Italic sees this object and makes this screenshot and says, finally, a usable object. It would be great if we could look deeper into it. I want it.
Aber auch hier von
Guladayi says, recorded, of course, with the robot.
The roof with the lantern and staircase, opposite to it with the pictures on the wall, maybe a small rack with the cable, curtains, I guess. Guess plenty of rooms in a house. Something cool spyish cam, smiley. Something cool spyish cam. Das ist Lob, was wir eigentlich nicht haben.
Something cool spyish cam, that's of course the kind of comment we didn't want to get.
Zu vermeintlichen technischen Fehlern. Also
a lot of critique for technical problems. Mission aborted, the robot sucks, I fell over.
Und in der Tat, also zu Recht, also wirklich gut beobachtet, das muss man vielleicht dazu sagen, wirklich gut beobachtet.
And indeed, somebody did make a nice, he did realize what happened. We of course had to go in and put the robot back up.
Schwarze Bildschirme beseitigen. Steuerung mit Maus ist zu optimieren.
Lerch, please remove the black screens. Please optimize the mouse controls. What am I doing anyway?
Hier natürlich durchaus ein bisschen Reflexion dann im dritten Kommentar.
There is some reflection in the third comment.
Kurz unsere eigene Verteidigung. Also dunkel.
And the darkness is of, because of the daylight time in April at quarter past nine. That's obviously pretty dark. There is no mouse at all. Improvement requests for improvement directed at some invisible institution, in this case us, even though they didn't know who we were. And the last example from Mario Scherf, from the 6th of April, seen four persons, positive, very cool. And you can see from this that people had fun using this hardware. And even we have to accept that we are having too much fun with the hardware. And with more time we put it, into it and more work we put into it, we're of course expecting more. And we said that vandalism would be okay, but it would not have been okay if the hardware stopped working. And nobody from our team is doing this professionally, so we needed some interface to maintenance teams. So during the investigation, we had an empty flat right next to the forsaken flag, and we had a control room there, and we could look at the streams and intervene if the robot fell over. But we got the streams directly from the from the flat, so we had additionally had to check if the streams arrived at the actual investigation station, and we had a camera dummy there, and we just before it started we transformed it into a working camera, so we had an additional stream from the investigation station. So there we were, the surveillance critical artists and the hackers.
It's so nice that this image shows what actually happened.
So
we didn't really, we were really entertained by the pictures and we commented about the users. And we were like birds of prey and, you know, we were looking at stuff they are doing. And of course, there was the wish to have more control. So we asked ourselves, why we only had this one camera, why don't we have a camera in the bar, and why don't we take the audio as well? And we decided against it.
And
while we were working on the project with our means, there was a new project in Leipzig where they there was a camera with a special power solution. And
the
stuff was estimated to about 8,000 euros. With more than a half of that, we made the whole project. So that shows how low-tech this technology is. And, you know, we working on the project, we didn't really look at the means we used. Even though we had artistical motivation, we made tools to make the whole opposite of what we actually wanted. Even the hacker team felt a little socially hacked by us, because we as artists, we showed our intentions so clearly and so nicely that they didn't really questioned our plans. So they were actually making surveillance software for us, and it's also a really dangerous point that we weren't so sure about. We as artists were instrumentalized, but we didn't really see that. On this Congress, I can stand here to ask something. But in this area, I can tell you openly about the project, because the experiences we made on this project are really good. The art is some kind of garden we're playing around, and we had some little scratches on our egos, but it wasn't really a big damage we made to society. And of course, there wasn't much moaning about our project, so we can stand openly here and talk about that. And actually, not only we make these assumptions, but also our users. In the beginning, we planned to reconstruct the place a few days after, and this was a station we used, and we took a few objects from the flat. That was actually topics in the comments, and we made videos and just had some kind of discourse, and we wanted to make the discourse. And a few weeks after, we closed the discussion forums, and some users were kind of surprised that they can use a joystick to drive through places, you know, even in the distance. They wouldn't have thought it would be so easy to steer something from the back room of a bar. And someone really had fun with it, and he thought it was a computer game, and now he knew that this was real. He was really surprised, because he's a woodworker, and he was always really cautious about going around other places and to save the privacy of the customers. And he didn't really, you know, he was asking himself if he was so cautious as we were in this flat, but it was kind of like a filter, and he thought he was like going around with a chainsaw through the whole flat. Well, a chainsaw might be a little exaggerating, but with this little probe camera, they were maneuvering through the whole flat. It was like a small mass mission in the flat, and they are again showing a video on that, where the rover is driving around and lighting the flat. Well, there's dust lying all around the flat, and this robot is actually driving, so it's also a little covered in dust when he moves. By the way, I highly recommend watching the replay of this session if you're just listening to the audio stream, because it's really nice to see those pictures of the flat where people are driving around with a rover.
Und der Staub, den wir jetzt
and the dust we see now,
der
this is
kommt
the dust
von einem Osterstrauß
coming from an Easter bouquet, standing around in this flat for 20 years on the living room desk.
In der Roboterfahrt
and in this rover drive, the driver actually knocked down the
und,
Easter bouquet.
Tja, vor dem Eingriff,
and before this,
da, hätte man ja, keinerlei, also gab es eigentlich keine Details.
There were no details in the flat.
Eigene Interpretation in eine bestimmte Richtung gelenkt.
That would actually lead people to a certain assumption. It was just, you know, they had the association of some kind of a crime scene. And there were just little changes we could do with technical devices. For example, like the rover, the probe. This Easter bouquet, some kind of waves in the carpets, some prints from shoes, and a dustbin in the kitchen. And to be honest, we've seen a few of the pictures. This was in the checkout phase. It was kind of difficult to track all these things down. There was a festival in Dresden last September, and we concentrated on this so-called the investigation. These are pieces from the flat, seven pieces, and the robot that were kind of showcased in cases of made of wood and glass, and they were kind of like a symbol. Symbol of what you can see from the neighbor window.
And
we didn't really want to be a historic museum, but you can see, for example, the Easter bouquet that was falling down.
And
behind these boxes, there was a projection. We already had
Even
before the examination on nine places, we had 360-degree pictures with panoramic images from the flat, and we made them before and afterwards to see how the changes happened and what changes happened. And we projected this behind these boxes. And that's what it looked like, basically. And it was dark in the flat, and so it's dark on the picture as well. And there was an interface like Google Street View, where you had a complete 360-degree view of the flat, and you can see the jump point where you can have a closer look at the pictures. You know, it's already dark, you know, because of all this greens growing around the house. There's a button on the left where you can switch between before and after. And if you look at the desk of in the living room, the chairs moved, for example, and
Des Weiteren ist vielleicht auch diese blauen Punkte zu erkennen.
There's a little blue dots that you can see. These are common points. We were interested in how people read this this exhibition and how do they read these little pieces. We didn't really want to remove pieces of our work there. And these people were on the festival and they could look at the real things we took from the flat with this digital representation of the flat and to compare it with it. And they also had the chance to look through this digital representation and to read comments from other people and from the people who were there in the first examination of the flat. And so what kind of collective story would build around this flat? How do people read this flat by using this Google apartment view? And this Google apartment view was some kind of trick we did. We wanted to bring it closer to normal life. And yeah, well, there's a rover, but it's kind of space age. So this is a technology we're using, but we wanted to have a more simple view, more known view, basically. And so how do people think about this and what do they make of it? And that's what I want to make sure about using some comments. For example, there's one from Ole from 2014. Nice oven, nice stove. There's Daddy's daughter. On next day, she thought, oh, nice flowers. And there's a next comment, this is not a nice cupboard. So we have three examples, and this is just like simple liking of the stuff they are seeing, like on Facebook. And there's some different people, different commenters who look more closely. So there's Dr. Watson,
Fest 13:59 in 4 Sekunden. Die Vase ist umgekippt.
The flowers fell down. The windows aren't open. Someone must have fallen down from cracking nuts.
Dann
Then there's the next comment.
Das Schlafzimmer.
Oh, about the sleeping room.
Man sieht das schon,
sehr viele Punkte. There's a lot of dots, so many people are discussing about it. And we might start on the left, on the pillow.
There's something
Space Invader Fake Cowboy is asking himself,
willst du hier aufwachen?
Whether you want to wake up at this point. And on the right side, from the red pillow, there's someone commenting with an answer. No, I want to die here on this pillow. Outside, the leaves will, and while I'm doing my last breath.
Und dann and then, wieder auf dem linken Kopfkissen,
again on the left pillow, there's a comment from Sausage.
Bezug nehmend auch auf die Frage
maybe,
von Space Invader Fake Cowboy.
Maybe it's on the question from Space Invader before.
Er hat vielleicht die Frage schon vergessen.
He maybe has also
willst du hier schlafen?
And he asked himself, do you want to ask here? No, you've got a bad breath.
Daraufhin wirklich ein paar, ja,
even
kurz
like
darauf,
only a bit ago, a bit later, from the same commenter, even from the Sausage.
In Klammern ist Pfefferminzbonbon.
Is eating a peppermint.
And so
closing, the dream team says apparently two people were living here.
So
we don't know if this is referencing Würstchen, Sausage or Fake Invader, or is it talking about the two pillows. So a very empathic comment can be found in the sleeping room or in the area just before that. And ich says, the poor person, he probably got under the... probably had love problems. He probably jumped down the bridge. He didn't have many chances in his age. But after 20 years, it should be more dusty. We thought so as well, but it isn't.
Dann findet abschließend,
and finally,
jemand diesen Sticker,
someone finds this sticker in the kitchen. I love my home.
Ja, senkrechter Strich gleich senkrechter Strich ergänzt. And we yours. Und ob das jetzt wirklich eine empathische Liebe
ist. And it says, and we yours. And if this is really an empathic love declaration to this flat, is really questionable. A art project like ours, of course, does not generate scientific answers. So we can't really answer this question.
But
of course, we as well started to love this flat as well. But as a place where we can talk and experience, and I hope I could transfer this to you, and hopefully we'll see in the Q&A session, and we would be very happy about this. Eva and some people from the technology team are there, and finally, we love Chaos Chemnitz and Sublab, and thanks a lot for your support.
So, wir haben jetzt noch ungefähr
12 to 13 minutes for questions.
Wenn ihr welche habt,
if you have any questions, please go to the microphones.
Mikrofon 3 bitte.
Microphone 3.
Hallo.
Hello.
Okay. Cooles Projekt.
Nice project.
Ich habe zwei Fragen, eine kurze,
two
eine
questions,
vielleicht
one shorter, one a bit longer.
Die kurze, die Salzstangen auf dem Tisch, waren von euch oder die standen noch da?
Were they from you or were they still there?
They were still there.
Erdnüsse gehen auch gut.
Und die andere Frage, waren auch Zeitzeugen da, die vielleicht sogar selbst überwacht waren? Were
they,
well,
people from that time there who maybe have experienced this flight before?
Hat sich jetzt jedenfalls nicht in den Kommentaren niedergeschlagen.
At least we didn't see that from the comments. Some more older people from the neighborhood were there, but how we talked to the people was difficult in reaching a broader community.
Hat sich das auf jeden Fall nicht niedergeschlagen.
At least we didn't see it.
Gut, dann Mikrofon 4 bitte.
So. Wie habt ihr die Leute in der Bar dazu gebracht, in diesen Kontrollraum zu gehen?
Make people
gemeint,
in the bar go to the control room. You said you didn't really make advertisements. How did people get to the idea to go in there?
It's a really simple trick. The bar is it's a back room and it's on the way to the toilet.
Muss man dann durch diesen Raum durch
oder
kommt
man durch
diesen
the room?
Genau, also man erreicht diesen Raum, indem man einfach durch den Flur geht und
no, but you pass by on your way to the toilet. And there were other projects before ours there, so the bar is open and people of course talk to each other, so they.
Gut, Mikrofon 1 bitte.
Ja, ich wollte fragen, welchen Grund es hatte, dass
die Wohnung nicht erleuchtet hat. Also for not lighting the flat in all movies, there were in all movies it was dark and
yeah, that would have been possible. Light would have been possible, but we wanted to minimize our impact on the flat. And we wanted to reflect on our first impression, and even at day, this flat is dark. So it was important that people could relive this. And the robot did have an infrared camera, but if we had used all the cameras with infrared, you could have seen the other cameras, and that would have been wrong. Because it wouldn't reflect on the.
And
did you find out what happened to the earlier tenant?
Yeah,
we did actually research that a bit. And for how long he's gone.
And
we do know nothing. We couldn't find anything. There's no information. And the people who lived there before, nobody knows anything.
Gut, Mikrofon 1 bitte.
In der Ausstellung, die nach
der Exhibition you made after the searchings in the flat, did people had to choose between the two images? Did they also see the protocols that people left there?
Du meinst in der Verhandlung quasi?
Ja.
Genau, in der Verhandlung gab es die Videos.
In this exhibition there was where the videos, for example, the video where the Easter bouquet falls, and of course it is a description.
Ein Video, also ein
and a split-screen video between the control room and what happened in the investigation room.
Das konnte man sich ja lesen. Ja, man konnte sich ja lesen.
You could see it from the surroundings.
Mikrofon 4, bitte.
Hatte die Vorbesitzerin mal gesagt, wieso sie
did the earlier owner tell you why this flat was empty for 20 years?
Yeah, that's exactly. Thank you for this question. It's very weird. It's not just some weirdness. Some flats are abandoned, but it needs some very specific political circumstances. So a thing like this, so it just stays like somebody just left over tens of years. So it was a very special situation to Chemnitz after the Berlin Wall fell, and the low, very few people asking for new flats in Chemnitz, so very specific to the Chemnitz situation. So the former owner didn't reflect that. There was no decision. It was just kept like that.
A question from the internet. On the IRC, is there a link to the Google View?
Nein, zu dem,
no.
Flat View oder Apartment View
to the apartment view, there is no link. Just without reliving the original objects, that's not a question for us. It would give a wrong illusion.
Noch eine. Sieht die Wohnung bis jetzt, also sieht die Wohnung immer noch
does
so
the flat still look like before, or is it empty now?
No, the
the
flat is just like after the investigation, plus what we took out.
Gut. Mikrofon 4, bitte.
Habt ihr den Probanden im Nachhinein dann erzählt,
did you tell the people looking at the flat that they were surveilled?
Yes, we told them, because to us this aspect, we didn't realize what happened with us. We didn't realize. And we did make a video documentation, so we kind of made some message to everyone, and then and which could be seen by everyone there. And there was a attention camera, and the camera was clearly visible. And originally the camera was planned to be a dummy, but that turned out to be not practical.
Gibt es sonst noch weitere Fragen?
Are there any more questions?
Ja, eine noch aus dem Internet. Ich kann das nur.
There's another question from the internet. What about the surveillance of the surveyors? Were there any reflections on this?
Nochmal bitte die über. Wie sah es mit dem Überwachen der Überwacher aus? Also wahrscheinlich, ob ihr überwacht.
So, how about you? People surveying you?
Unsere. Also tatsächlich gab es
after the fact, we of course weren't surveilled. There was this control room, but we did film us ourselves. There was a camera filming us, but there was no additional person behind that camera. So there was no live stream, and we of course reflected that ourselves, and then we were.
Gut, ich sehe eine weitere Frage. Zwei. Mikrofon 3 bitte zuerst.
There's one more question in the room.
Was hat es so besonders gemacht?
What made it so special to talk about the flat being 20 years old? I mean, you could have done that with any flat that you can actually make yourself with even more interesting artistical stuff where people can reflect more.
Yeah, that's possible. But it would be a very different project. What the special thing about the 20-year abandoned flat was that it was out of time. It was important. It was not a personal surveillance. So this is why we used the Mars mission as a symbol. So we were kind of doing an archaeological mission, not just the neighbor's flat.
Vielleicht auch eher darum, wie man Dinge exploriert.
It may be more about how we explore things using technical means. Maybe surveillance would be one possibility, but it could happen in other places. How empathic are we? How can we feel things? How could we feel it if we were physically there?
Das freut mich.
Mikrofon 2, bitte.
Wie hat sich denn der
How did the new owner of the flat talk about this this whole project?
Reflektiert?
Did he actually reflect?
The owner again is a supporter of many people in Chemnitz.
And
we couldn't really get the answer from him. He came to us and said, "Here's this flat. You have to do some art." Art has to happen here. And so we asked him, how did you come to this conclusion? And he said, it was obvious.
Das ist toll, das ist ja eigentlich eine, ja genau, ich finde eigentlich, das ist vielleicht, jetzt habt ihr angefangen, ich habe euch im Applaus unterbrochen, ich finde eigentlich auch, es ist viel Applaus wert. Weil das ist natürlich
and I interrupted your applause, but I think it's worth a lot of applause. And of course we as artists think, okay, here there has to be some art, but some other people may not react to that like it. And so we were happy that someone came to us with this.
Gut, Mikrofon 1 bitte.
Moin. Was habt ihr euch denn für Gedanken über die Gestaltung?
What thoughts did you make yourself about the design of the control room where the people sat? It was a bit like a surveillance control room. Didn't you actually change reception?
Yeah, that may have played a role. You may have wondered, what is this? We tried to make it look pretty old, like a work environment. And of course, we used control rooms from power plants and so on as a example. And there's a very famous picture where drone pilots are being trained, and of course that was an important reference for us. So just to create a work environment, not a design bureau, but how we would imagine such a control room.
Gut, Mikrofon 3 bitte.
Ja, cool. Plant
nice
ihr
project.
Euer Überwachungsmaterial zu vernichten?
Do you plan to destroy your surveillance material?
Currently, we're very proud that we managed to back up all of it.
Ist tatsächlich nicht geplant, nein.
No, it's not planned.
Gut, eine weitere Frage aus dem Internet.
From the IRC, if you can still remember what was on the Lebkuchenheart.
Many greetings from a place with four letters. I don't remember.
Gut, Mikrofon 1 bitte.
Gab's so Situationen, wo dann...
Were there situations where neighbors came, were like, oh wow, now I take the chance to have a look at that flat.
Surprisingly not, no. And especially the connection, thanks for this question, it was a very interesting moment. The connection, this could be in my neighborhood. A lot of people didn't realize or realized it very, very late. It's just a monitor to somewhere. But it could be, of course, the room from someone who could just return any moment. And people are just watching it without thinking about it. And that apparently didn't...
How long did people sit at the steering and drove the rover?
No, the usage varied widely. Some people returned several times. The first tries, just people touch the joystick, the robot turns around and falls over. And so it was very different. And it, of course, depends on how much people are used to using hardware devices. And the video we saw was one of the good users or the experienced users who apparently had some gaming experience, and many users had problems steering this robot through the flat.
Your project is a little unconventional, if you want to say so. I know art when you are in a museum looking at pictures hanging on walls. I would be interested in what's your self image of you as an artist and the intention of your art. What is it about the experience, about your own knowledge gain? Because it's not really scientific what you're doing. Is it a question you should ask yourself?
The question about our intention, of course, is important. So just very short, we feel like we're context artists, and that means that we don't just use a question as a sculptor, but we searched for the technical means to use this project, even though we hadn't done anything like that before. And it's not as much about the piece of art that can be placed in the museum, which would be nice, maybe, but it's more about the discourse, that the experience, the how people can together talk about, and of course you can misbehave, and the text marker that has been stolen, that's completely all right, and damaging the station, that would have been great. But what happens after that, a group of person who can discuss this and talk about how do we want this, and that's very different in a real world.
So thank you. So this is even about the discourse we're doing right now.
Yes, of course. That's very important.
Gut, eine weitere Frage aus dem Internet.
Okay, next question from the internet. Was there vandalism or theft in the exhibition?
As I said, there actually was. It's a very interesting situation. You're being surveilled. And exactly that happens, someone steals a text marker. So do we really want to know that? I'm not sure about that. And this theft, of course, is not really relevant. But vandalism, there was none.
Gut, dann da unsere Zeit fast abgelaufen ist, die letzte Frage bitte.
So, the last question.
Ja, gab es in der Wohnung Hinweise
auf die... Were they hints on the identity of the previous owner, or have you looked for them in the flat? It could might have been a little not so nice with this art.
Yes, there were hints to the identity of the owner, and when you visit our website, we... talk about the tenant as Mr. U, and we know more, so things that we won't tell you. There was letters with names and so on, but we looked at the streams, they couldn't look at that, and we made sure that the Zoom was locked to a place that people couldn't read.
So, and this concludes. There's so much to do. Let's just leave. Thank you for listening in. If you have feedback to the translators, tweet at